Chirand we got Bihar. So these are the important factors. These are the important aspects we got from the Neolithic age. Like that one more age that is called as a metal age. So what is the meaning of metal age? The name it was indicates the metals. So what are the metals they were used? See, the end of the Neolithic period, the almost all of the people, they were used the metals. So that it is called as a metal age. The first metal we called as copper. The end of the Neolithic age or the metal age, we found a copper. This copper is the first metal. Like that they were producing a bronze by mixing the tin and the copper. Bronze also we got there. How they were made the bronze? How they were made the bronze? So they were made the bronze by mixing the tin and the copper. By mixing the tin and the copper. Like that the bronze is a alloy. The bronze is one of the alloy and it is harder than copper. These are the things especially we got from the metal age. In the metal age we found the copper and the bronze stone age also. This copper and bronze stone age especially we got before 5000 years ago. Before 5000 years ago, in this age we found the metal weapons and also a stone weapons. Metal weapons and also a stone weapons. So it is named as a grand stone culture. So why it is called as a grand stone culture? In this metal age, the stone weapons also continue. So it is named as a grand stone age. Like this way, in a copper and bronze age, we found a agricultural activities and also a cattle rearing. In a copper and bronze stone age, we found the agricultural activities and also a cattle rearing. This agricultural activities and the cattle rearing gives a good profit to this age. Like this way, we found the designed parts. We found the designed parts. We know that in the Neolithic age people, they already introduced the wheel. By using some of the wheel, they were made a designed parts. These kind of the designed parts is helpful to store the food. Like this way, we found the many of the jewelries. So these kind of the jewelries was made by the copper and the bronze. Like this, many of the human beings, they were used a good type of the jewelries. Like this way, the conversion of the forest into a cultural land or cultivated land. How they were convert the forest land into a cultivated land? By using some of the metals. So what we called as a bronze, copper and also a stone. So these are the weapons they were used to convert the forest land into a cultivated land. So why they were need the cultivated land? Because they want to do the agriculture. They want to settle in a one place. So that they were made this land as a cultivated land. And this age, they were transport the food grains, those who needy. Some of the places we cannot get the good condition of the crops. At that time, these people, they were transport the food grains to one place to another place. Like this way, this copper and the bronze stone age, especially we got the Sindhu River tributaries. Sindhu River tributary. In that Sindhu River tributary, we found one of the good civilization or the first civilization that is called as a Harappa civilization. The many of the historians and the scientists gives a information about the Harappa civilization in a Sindhu River tributary. Like this, it is one of the first urbanization civilization. It is one of the first urbanization civilization. This copper and the bronze stone age, especially we got in a South India. In a South India, the use of the bronze was less than the copper. So that the South Indian people, the almost all they use the copper. Like that these kind of the copper, bronze, stone age sites we got in a Karnataka also. So what are those? The places we called as Alluru, Vanahalli, Brahmagiri. So these are the places that gives the information about the copper, bronze, stone age. Like this way, we found the iron stone age. Iron stone age. Why it is named as iron stone age? Because with the metals, they were used the stone weapons. The stone weapons, it was continued in the iron age also. So it is named as a iron stone age. So in iron stone age, we found before 3500 years ago. Like this way, it's a hard metal. Iron, it is one of the hard metal compared to copper and bronze. It is one of the hard metal. This hard metal, especially we got in a South India. not in a northern part of the India. The almost all of the South Indian people, they use the iron. Like that, it's a period of a grand stone culture. It's a period of a grand stone culture, and a stone circle, it was constructed around the chamber. See, we know that in the time of the Neolithic age people, when they were died, they were kept the dead body into a stone chamber or stone circled chamber. Like that, in iron stone age also, we found the stone circle constructed around the chamber. We call it as a tomb. And in that, they were kept the dead body. So these kind of the things, especially we got in a iron stone age, which that in a chamber they were kept the red and block colored parts. So these kind of the red and block colored parts also they were placed in a chambers. So these kind of the chambers they used to call as a hut or house of the Pandavas or stone of a Mauryas. Hut or house of the Pandavas or stone of a Mauryas. So these kind of the names specially we got from the Karnataka. Like this, they were useful to do the agriculture and handicrafts. So these kind of the metals, so these kind of the iron, it was useful to do the agriculture and handicraft. So that always they were used the iron metal, which that they are increased in North India. So these kind of the iron metal, it was increased to a North India also. Before, we cannot get in a North India. The almost all of the South India people only use the iron. Like this way, the North India people also they use the iron. Like that, agrarian activities and surplus aid also we got there. So these are the republic states we got before 2600 years ago. Like this, so what are the republic states in the sense we are remembering? Nanda and Maurya. Nandas and Mauryas. So with that we found Banahalli, Koppa, Hekkadehalli, Hiregadakkallu and Brahmagiri, T. Narasipura, Hemmige, Halluru, Jadagenahalli, Samanadurga, Putri Durga, Pandavara Dinne. So these are the sites, these are the places we found the Iron Age sites. With that we found the different type of the tombs. So what are the different type of the tombs we got in the Iron Stone Age? Especially used to name as a stone circle, menhir, dolmen, khair and ur. So these are the important chambers or the tombs we got in a iron stone age. Dear students, today we learnt many things from this lesson. Especially Neolithic age, metal age. In the metal age we learnt copper and bronze stone age and iron stone age. So these are the factors, so these are the aspects helpful to learn about the prehistoric society. Thank you.